Your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Good morning and welcome to Guardian Radio AM. Today is Wednesday, November 8th. Until after 11 o'clock in the morning, once again, this is C.A. Newry and I shall be your host for the day as we join shows with On the Clock with Aaron Green to have one show, a mashup show where we analyze the news. Today is Man Down, May Day, Mashup Day, and of course we have Ian Munnings with us as we continue our analytical approach to the upcoming pending by-election and of course the upcoming pending
PLP convention.
Today, I want us to analyze the news, but I have two important clips I want to play. I haven't let Erin hear it yet, because her inbox is not as nice as mine, but I want her to listen to it, and of course, Ian is here, and we're going to analyze it. What does it mean? And we're going to have these two clips juxtaposed, right? And then you, the listening audience, I want you to call in, and you tell me. What should we anticipate for the PLP's by-election and of course and the PLP's by-election, the PLP's convention, and of course Grand Bahama's by-election, West End?
This thing follow you from show to show.
Yeah.
You already announcing winners.
Yeah. Anyway. So producer, play that first clip for me. I go quiet right now.
We need someone who understands the system and understands a nation that is in crisis to the level our nation is. Brave Davis is a statesman, a parliamentarian. He is an astute QC and he understands analytical problem solving. That is where we are. The country is demanding servant leaders in this season of our national existence. And, you know, show me a parliamentarian whose competence exceeds that of Brave Davis. Show me a parliamentarian whose abilities exceed him. Show me a parliamentarian whose understanding of the Westminster system exceeds him. Show me anyone. This is about skill. This is about competence. I don't mind what anyone says. Crisis calls for crisis management. You don't bring someone into crisis management who may be able to do the task. You bring someone who's tried, who's tested, who is proven, and I dare someone to show me someone who exceeds that capacity when put against a Brave Davis. That is how I make my decision.
And that was Miss Robin Lyons, who is vying for the chairman of the Progressive Liberal Party. She said this maybe one day before, like you said, Brave Davis, mash up and say you don't support her.
No, sir. Hold on. Pause. Don't do that.
She said, I ain't support her. I ain't support her. What? 24 hours?
No, sir.
She said that.
Stop, and then stop. You know, okay. No.
It was 24 hours?
No. She referenced Brave Davis, the QC.
Okay.
Which means that the speech must have been given before the death of Queen Elizabeth.
Second.
Yeah, because she would have referenced him as Casey and not QC.
My point is, she said in there,
that's what you worried
about. She needs somebody with crisis management, problem solving, who understands analytical approach,
decision making.
That's what you.
And my leader.
See, guys, all week, concluded that somebody else fits that job. So I said, I wanted to put that on record to analyze irony. I know how what irony means. Irony. There you go, Aaron.
Listen, that's what I wanted to know. Why didn't Robin Lyons put on her resume that she worked for Avon? Because that was a whole lot of lotion.
That was a lot of lotion, eh? Then that later was on, only to say, she ain't the one. That's why I don't lotion people to know. Because you tell me I ain't the one after I lotion you.
Sometimes you have to caress.
You know what I mean? A vouch like that. You know what it is to vouch for somebody like that?
Heavy.
And then they turn around. See, it's not a matter of not endorsing me, you know. You don't have to endorse me. That's cool. Mm-hmm. This is a democracy. The whole point, you have a convention, you have elections. The whole point is for people to run. That's why you have elections. Mm-hmm. So I don't have a problem with you not endorsing me. What I would have a problem with is that you publicly mashing me up.
Public opinion.
Knowing that you already hold the weight of the party's resources, the party's power, the party's influence. Why did you need to mash me up publicly after I did such a good job vouching for you?
Who mash up who? I'm trying to understand what you're trying to say. Are you going to get your
I don't have to say it.
She's going to read the article.
The Prime Minister said it.
Okay, but what did the Prime Minister exactly say? Because I have one more voice note I want to stand in line.
Prime Minister Brave Davis last night said he was surprised when former Senator Robin Lyons decided to run for chairman. He said, while, quote, she doesn't have my support, close quote, that no one had to be given the okay to run.
Somebody just doesn't have his support.
That in and of itself may not seem like, a mashing up. What compounds it and affirms it for me is the absence of admonition by the Prime Minister to those people who would purport to be elements of the party that are mashing her up. See, in and of itself, that seems like an innocuous statement. She doesn't have my support, but I can't stop her from running. Right? Mm-hmm. But he also didn't come back and say to my party generally, just because somebody is challenging a position, just because they don't have my support, that doesn't mean you are now endorsed to mash them up.
Or is he discouraging people by his statement that, or by his admission that she doesn't have his support? That is he hinting that someone else has his support?
The writing is on the wall.
Because, there's another person.
The writing is on the wall.
Another person said they have the support of the Prime Minister.
It's implied.
I said that the writing is on the wall. The reality is that we are faced with either we had a step of the change of the guard, or are we going to remain the same? The reality is Robin Lyons is a young individual who's put herself in position, who has proven that she can handle the weight. We have currently now a sitting chairman
who was the minister. What's your proof that she could handle the weight?
She's new. She's young. She's vibrant. We've had somebody that's sat in that same exact seat for the last... How long?
When's the last time the PLP had a convention?
I'm saying how long. That's my point.
Hold on. But when's the last time the PLP had a convention?
But that's my point.
2019, right? Mm-hmm. The PLP constitution requires a convention every year. In fact, at the 2019 convention, they attempted to change the constitution to have a convention every 2 years, and the party said, no, we want a convention every year. What is the proof that Robin Lyons can hold the weight? Has she been able to compel her party to follow its own constitution? And as a chairman, does she have the capacity? Will she be able to cause or compel her party to follow its own constitution as chairman? I stand with anybody who wants to stand, but that doesn't mean that I'm not going to vigorously interrogate, right, their capacity to do what it is they're volunteering for. And I don't consider that mashing somebody up. Because we could have a similar conversation about Mitchell. Mm-hmm. We could have a similar conversation about Gibson, the one who wanted to run, who started the whole we running
yes.
fiasco.
But Aaron and Ian, I have another voice note I want to play. And Jason, get a producer. I have another voice note I want to play. So put that on and play that, and then we'll analyze this. What does this mean? Go ahead, producer.
Good morning. This is Fred Mitchell, chairman of the Progressive Liberal Party, Minister for Foreign Affairs, MP for Fox Hill. Today is Wednesday, the 8th of November, 2023. In a few days' time, I will face the verdict of voters in the PLP convention. It has been an interesting campaign, getting to visit and talk with party members all across the country to hear their wishes and concerns. It is summed up by the theme of our convention, which speaks to building on the progress we have made and plotting a course for the future. Built on that progress, I have been happily a part of that process, working along with a team that included the Prime Minister Philip Brave Davis, Deputy Prime Minister Chester Cooper, and Barbara Cartwright, our Secretary General. There are scores of vice chairs, the treasurer, our committees and branch leaders, that brought us from the agony of defeat in 2017 to where we are today. The party determined that it had to shuffle off the heritage of late again to debunk the myths about corruption. Yet, of course, every goodbye is not gone. The common advice has been that if we did not deal with that, the whole ship would sink. Generally speaking, it's been a good campaign, save for some miscreants who sought not to appeal to policy, but to prejudice, seeking to portray a dedicated public servant who crafted a new constitution, put in place a training program module for candidates or aspirants, defended the party at every turn and every corner, and most importantly in recent times, refused to return to the past. The memes passing around from opponents are shameful and shady and nasty. And yet you ask yourself, why would any candidate who wants to be a chair would be associated with matters that are so prejudicial? It's very, very sad. Power cannot be that sweet. But this race is not about gender bias or feminism or ageism. This is about a simple request of all delegates to the PLP convention. So whether you are poor or rich, whether young or not so young, in Abaco or in Agua, all of our islands, in fact, to be brave and support Philip Brave Davis, our leader and prime minister, on Friday, the 10th November, 2023, by voting for Fred Mitchell, that's me, for chairman of the PLP. I've enjoyed my visit to Andros yesterday. Thank you to Bacchus Roll and the people of South Beach. I spoke to them. And then I spoke to Mario Boleg and the people of Garden Hills. Thank you, Leon Lundy, for your arranging the meeting with Sylvanus Petty and Kirk Cornish, who visited with us in Andros. So let us.
Okay. So miscreants in the party was attempting to cause mischief. And in fact, a person running for chairman of the party associated themselves with these miscreants who wants to, let me see if I get rid of it, attempting to return back to the party where the party had what the word they use? Had the aura of corruption.
Myth of corruption. I'd stick a pen, I can read the whole quote.
Miscreant. That's how you pronounce the word.
But
no, I pronounce the word.
Miscreant.
Yeah, thanks.
You know where I would start my investigation?
At the miscreant?
Yeah, looking for those miscreants?
Yes.
BahamasUncensored.com. I would just start there. A wealth of information. I would start there. Because there's miscreants within the party.
Yes.
Yeah.
Who are persons who are attempting to run for chairman is associating themselves with.
Right. That's where I would start. But let me read that whole, because that was what, wow. Here's a quote. I'm just going to reiterate a quote from that little voice clip.
And that came out today, by the way. That I says November 8th.
Wednesday. Mm-hmm.
Shuffle off the heritage of late again to dispel the myth of corruption.
That means this administration inherited a myth of what again?
Corruption.
Of corruption. Who was the leader at that time that this new leader inherited this myth of corruption?
Shuffle off the heritage of late again to dispel the myth of corruption.
And the PLP was labeled late again leader.
Shuffle off the heritage of late again.
I believe the chairman was talking about Team Christie.
He couldn't be talking about Team Christie.
He wasn't talking about Team Christie?
No, he couldn't have been. He couldn't have been. I mean, that's what it seems like, right? Because it even seems like he was intimating or suggesting. Now, dear audience,
quotation.
There's a difference between imply and infer. I infer from what I heard just now that he is suggesting that Lyons is also Team Christie. But here's my thing. What's the problem with Team Christie? Because Obi was Team Christie. And we're doing this one for Obi. So I don't see what the problem is.
Obi was the last one to get his nomination. He was Team Christie. But we're doing this for Obi. In fact, we opening airports in his name.
We launching programs and projects in his name.
But the team...
We rushing in his name. We marching in his name. We church servicing in his name.
All of them are part of that miscreants.
We campaigning in his name.
Those miscreants want to return to that myth of whatever. I need to write down these quotes. Listen, so I can be able to quote it properly, man.
Quote, shuffle off the heritage of late again to dispel the myth of corruption. Right on that.
Who was referred to as late again?
Sir, we done been past that being.
Late again.
You late again, Mr. Munnings.
This is why I want to analyze too. There's a chairmanship race. At this present time in Grand Bahama West End, the chairman is not present. However, the chairman is now doing a tour to various, what do you call it, delegation place? What do you call them? Where the delegations be?
Constituencies.
Constituencies. But I want to know, is the person who's challenging the chairman, did they go to constituency to have they come to Fox Hill to talk to us yet? Or they can try win just from where they at.
I wouldn't come to Fox Hill.
You don't come to Fox Hill. But I mean, my point is.
Pause. Let me rephrase that. Fox Hill people are beautiful people. This is not an aspersion.
No. I wouldn't shoot it. Anyway. My point is, we know that campaigning is happening for the chair. We know that the campaigning is happening for West Grand Bahama. And I'm watching who all is doing the campaigning. In West Grand Bahama, we see the Prime Minister or the leader of the party, and we see the deputy leader of the party. We even see some members of parliament on the ground campaigning.
Mm-hmm.
In the various constituencies and the family islands, we see a chairman who is campaigning and meeting and greeting and encouraging and what chairmans do.
Yeah.
But I want to know what is the challenger for the chair? Who associate themselves with the miscreants?
What can she do after having to pay $1,500?
My question is, when will some people sail into the sunset? When is your official time is enough?
So it's a wave, sir?
I said when. When is it officially enough?
When are we ready?
It's not when we're ready.
When are we ready?
The reality is this. In order for you to foresee change, we have to be embraced by something new. But the reality is these people in their 70s and 80s, and what are they really going to offer us at this point?
I do not appreciate what you're trying to say about my 72-year-old prime minister.
Stick a pin.
I don't like it. I don't like it, and you need to stop it.
Ian.
You're the agent.
Yes, the problem is,
stop it.
The problem is with the language that we use, right? We don't need to get rid of them. They have extreme value. In fact, the nature of the relationship has to change because you have this institutional knowledge and expertise that can only be gained from being in the space. See, that's the thing right there. You have this thing, expertise that can only be gained from being in the space. But gaining that expertise does not give you a right to
entitlement.
Right. That's right. Thank you. That doesn't entitle you to own that space. And let's use your good MP,
yes,
the good chairman of the PLP, mm-hmm, and the good minister of foreign affairs. I still on the line about good chairman of the PLP, but I give him good minister of foreign affairs and good MP.
Yes.
Perfect example. Mr. Mitchell is the only political figure, politician or government actor that could lead a transition to a republic. The only one.
I will go on a limb and echo Aaron and say, if they want to go to be a republic, more likely Mr. Mitchell needs to be there.
Right?
I'm not sure if Langs has that type of experience or if it's important to her.
There are some grand governance initiatives that we say we want, that we say we're going to embark on. And you look at the political landscape, Mr. Mitchell gets to be on the team. In fact, this is one of those instances where it can't be bipartisan. It has to be a whole push. Like the Republic, every team got to be involved. And Mitchell is the brain, got to be there.
What the evidence?
Pause. But Mitchell can't be there if he insists that he's entitled to be there because he's the only person that has the experience in the role. He then has to be able to shift to a place where we acknowledge his institutional knowledge as extremely valuable, but he also acknowledges that he can't just be entitled to that space because he has that knowledge. He has to figure out how to transfer that knowledge. Now, he could say, I'm doing a good job at that, but get right back to the voice note where he referenced the person who created the learning module, right? The candidates, the program for candidates in the PLP to teach them about being a parliamentarian.
Let's pause there. Let's pause there.
Oh, because you know what I'm about to say.
No, I want you to say what you want to say. My point is, who is he intimating is that person?
Well, either it's him or it's Kingsley Smith.
It sounded to me like it was Kingsley Smith who wrote the program, because they said they were critiquing him and miscreants were saying that he's not up for the job.
Right. So it's either Kingsley Smith up for the job for by-election or Fred Mitchell up for the job for chairman. Right?
So what are your predictions?
Hold on, pause. We didn't get to predictions yet.
We got
to
predict.
No, pause. We didn't get there yet. The point I'm making is this, is that the lack of gazetting of the summary declarations and public disclosures list, the continual bumbling by politicians about what their parliamentary obligations are, suggests to me that that program is not as good as they're painting it. And is that truly a good endorsement for Smith or for Mitchell, whoever wrote the program? Because he wasn't clear with that. That's the point I will make. The next point I will make is this, and we get to your point. One boy have daily lives, and one boy have daily voice notes. What's the difference between a daily voice note and a daily vlog? What's the difference, Mr. Newry?
One comes at 8 o'clock in the p.m. and one
comes at 8 o'clock in the a.m.
Live at 8 p.m. And the next one comes every morning.
One you can see physically and one you can hear.
Ah, boy. Okay. You say you want predictions?
Give me a prediction.
For what? Convention or by election?
Convention. Chairman's base.
The party can get what it wants.
And that's reference to say what?
Whatever the party decides is what it decides. See, I'm not PLP, so I don't necessarily care. I would love to make commentary afterwards. That's where I come in.
All of the prediction is premised on whether you believe these people are telling the truth or not. Do I believe that the Prime Minister is telling the truth when he says publicly that he does not support Robin Lyons? Simple. The party will get what the party wants. That's my prediction. I don't know what the party wants because I'm not a member.
My concern, and where the analytical point that come out, can Ms. Lyons survive after this chairman election, right? If once you, after being labeled miscreant, can you, a miscreant, or a supporter of miscreants, or on the side of miscreants, can you offer yourself a next year, one more, in another
did
chairmanship?
Did Leslie Miller survive?
Leslie's man.
Did Shane Gibson survive?
He's man. This woman we talking about, this party.
So you're saying, can women political actors survive after getting mashed up?
You try to put words in my mouth.
Has Glenys Hannah Martin survived?
She ain't being a leader no more. She stopped that. She stopped that ambition. That ambition finished. Stay right where she at.
I got a prediction for you, Ian. I predict the PLP go offer two women. They go offer three women in the next election.
We go down less or go up more?
Down. Glenys, Pia, Leslie. That's it.
And that.
So what happened to Jobet?
Jobet and Lisa. Lisa doing a good awesome job. No, yeah, calling the woman Lisa. But she's doing a good job. You believe that they would go down? No, man. The PLP got to go up.
Have you heard the commentary from people purporting to be PLP supporters about women in leadership?
They don't like women. The PLPs seemingly just don't like women. They just be harsh with them.
I'm just saying, have you seen a female member of the party get up and publicly declare support for Robin?
If they're smart, they won't.
See, because what I did was, I Robin and I don't necessarily have the same politics, but I could still stand and say, you have the right to stand, and you have the right to stand without this. You know what the worst part of it is? The covert violence. People don't come out and slap you. They send somebody to slap you, right? Like that's... Nobody's even stood up and said...
I think I get you. Like, these are women who are in a male-predominant kind of atmosphere
but
when it comes to politics, right?
Senior roles.
And you're saying you're looking at these women who are now challenging the frontline politics, and you're saying you don't see enough of them standing up even to say that, hey, I'm endorsing a fellow sister in regards to the chairmanship, And I believe that she will be...
Well, no, see, this is it. Not even endorsing her. I'm just standing up and saying, what is all of this noise about? Does she not have the right to run? That's it. I don't have to endorse her politics. I don't even have to say I want her to be the chairman.
If that noise was going to be her hair, too, I think only one female within the party would have the unction to do so.
Loretta Butler-Turner?
Probably Glennis.
She's good. I don't believe Hannah Martin has that ambition anymore, that drive, that energy.
I'm saying if we would have seen it, we would have seen it
from her.
Through her, yes. Right. Yes.
Right, like I said, I if she was going to pick up A.D. Hannah's PLP party and take it to somewhere it could flourish, she would have done it by now.
She would have done it by now. And,
yeah.
And since she hasn't done it, she's not interested.
And so my prediction is that this is going to fare poorly for the PLP, and that if the women in the party don't take a stand now, not having to, and to make the distinction, we're not endorsing her for chairman. We're endorsing that she has the right to run free of this violence. That women will continue to get mashup
violence. This is politics. If you are unable to shoulder the chafing, then you should not be in politics.
Get out of it.
The political culture is violent. And while you may think that it's innocuous and bounded by the political space only, I offer to you, political parties that cannot moderate violence within their own parties cannot effectively implement or enforce policies to eradicate violence in various spheres of the country. So don't even get to the table and tell me you're prepared to spend millions of dollars on programs to eradicate violence because, A, you don't have the political will, nor do you have the capacity to eradicate violence. That's why it's important.
You know, Aaron, for me, when we get into the political conversations, it's fine. But at the end of the day, I think that even when these people are elected, the true element of this is that the Bahamian people should be your number one focus. We're looking at West Grand Bahama and those persons that didn't have light and their situations are living in cars and all of these particular, these are Bahamian people. These are the Bahamian people. We've seen where three sitting members of one particular party are sitting in the seat, and these people have been there in these and having these challenges, and we have yet to see.
Perfect example. Let me just reiterate it. A political culture that does not allow you to address your social or community infrastructural needs or needs outside of a political lens. They refuse to tolerate any conversation about your needs as a citizen outside of the realm of politics. I had a personal experience with that. We're in a WhatsApp group, and I'm saying to somebody who has some influence in the group, hey, any movement on including the provisions on regulation of current and distribution systems, because last week, 2 weeks ago, we were informed that those provisions were not brought over to the 2015 Electricity Act. And I say, I asked the person of influence, has there been any movement on adding those provisions to the new act so that we have another strategy to attempt to resolve our community issue? And I was accused of being political. The person wasn't being political. The person is just caught up in this political culture, right? You trying to talk about a community issue and those that are responsible for solving it refuse to allow you to talk about it outside of the bounds of politics.
But this is where it gets...
That's violence.
This is where it gets a little bit tricky,
but
right?
Hold on. We got a caller for the first time in 30 minutes. Producer, let's go to the caller. Good morning, caller.
Good morning to you, Madam Green. Madam Green.
Morning,
I mean, you are doing such an excellent score today. I'm telling you, it makes the young people feel good to know that there is people who want to take us, who truly take us into the future. The next generation that we're talking about, the next generation of leaders they were talking about. But mm-hmm. I just want to remind you all too today,
yes.
That remember, it was the women that had the PLP to get where they are today.
Mm-hmm.
And it was the same, he is knocking the women away to be the same ones who have them as part of it. What do we look at the UPP now? The UBD story yesterday, we didn't see them today, right? So the PLP is shutting themselves up to become exempt from this political move. They allow them to carry on smartly. They don't even understand what's going on. Women carry them where they are, mm-hmm. and it's the same women who they're trying not to go further is going to be their downfall. And I am telling you that today. You say what's your prediction? That is my prediction today.
Yes, ma'am.
Have a blessed day.
Thank you.
All that passion, Aaron, for people who have a job to make fritters.
Make the fritters, man.
Mr. Newry. Mr. Newry.
We know what the PLP. Anyway, text says, what political violence is Aaron intimating? Was the police called to investigate these violent acts she's talking about? Was there any arrest or convictions? That is very dangerous to suggest something like that without evidence.
Dear texter, let me share with you that in 2007, the Domestic Violence Act was amended to expand the definition of violence, right? And the law now recognizes that violence is not just limited to physical violence where we slap, punch, or shoot each other, but psychological violence, social violence, structural violence, financial violence, emotional violence.
Aaron, let's go to the
next. But we do have instances
of
violence breaking out among party supporters.
You support miscreants inside the party.
Says an Aaron with the Barry Christie crew.
Yeah, she's in with that crew. She supports miscreants. And we don't support. We try to have a new
You
PLP.
Wasn't in London with me when I used to take the shuttle, the shuffle. You don't know about these things, sir.
We have a text says, please stop, CA. No one nominated more women candidates than the PLP. So we can't say that the party is not for women.
To do what? To fight for this?
How many women did they nominate out of 38? See, when you analyze
the
numbers.
Yeah, about numbers, seven. Not even seven.
Let's get the caller. Let's get to the caller.
Good morning, caller.
Go ahead, caller.
Good morning. How y'all doing?
Good, thank you.
Doing well.
From a woman's perspective, I'm calling in.
Yes, ma'am.
I would hope one day when women offer themselves, not only in politics for leadership and in every area, mm-hmm. but we stop using the woman card. I would hope that we would show our strength and stop just falling on the woman card for sympathy.
Yes,
That's
ma'am.
My desire one day. Every time you hear a woman offer herself, whether from any area, we as women, we always come up with this woman card. We just thinking in our minds. We're not hearing it out there. But we thinking in our minds.
Yes, ma'am.
I would hope one day that we would come into this and we would use the strength, woman's strength, instead of using woman, the woman card, all the time, because that person is a woman. Because of, no, let us show our strength. Thank you.
Absolutely. That's why I tell Ian, we can stand with her and mash her up.
CSA, my endorsement, the conference.
Listen, my endorsement is not because, oh, she should get the spot because she's a woman. My endorsement is not, oh, she's a woman and I'm a woman, so I must endorse her. My endorsement is she should be allowed to run free of violence. Eradicate the violence entirely. So that we could get to the real work, which is questioning whether she has the capacity to lead the party as chairman. Well, see, there's two separate issues.
But the violence that she's incurring, you're saying, is it verbal violence?
It's verbal. It's definitely verbal and psychological.
Me personally, I believe in affirmative action. By being in a Pan-Africanist and knowing that certain spaces is not allowed to us, and it's harder for us to get in. There are certain spaces, and particularly in politics, where women are not easily accepted. If women try to push their way into a man's realm, we will mash them up. Only way they can get an access to the front is through affirmative action, mm-hmm. where we make effort to say we will include more women. So I heard a lady who said, oh, women should just fight on their own. But without men seeing the need that to include women, it'll be like churches where we said women should not be bishops, women should not be pastors, women should not be talking in church at all.
What?
Right?
CA?
And that's the narrative.
And so,
but if we don't make space for them, they will be excluded.
And so
we will start hunting them down like they used to do with the witches of yesteryears.
And
they'll be regressed to fry and furnace for trouble.
And I'm not saying stop being violent to her because she's a woman. I'm saying eradicate this level of violence from politics entirely. But more, hold on. But more importantly, don't be putting out disingenuous voice notes like that. Don't be going around the place watching, endorsing through your silence entities connected to you, engaging people with the most foul, hold on, with the most foul language, and then create a voice note pretending like you don't understand what these people are talking about, or that you don't engage, or that members of your party that you are fighting to maintain control of don't engage in the very same behavior.
I want to ask you, just reading the headlines here, it stated that PINTAD, the FNM's under new management with new vision. My question to you is that in this by-election that the PLP and the FNMs and the COIs, they're about to run in the West Grand Bahama and Bimini. We would say that some monies will be spent to this by-election. Is that same effort, have we seen that effort aiding these persons within the development of those particular areas?
Why money,
that is the question I want
why
to ask.
Money only spent at election time?
I'm just asking during this time.
No, so you don't have to ask it. Let me ask it because you're a nice guy.
Because
why does it appear that money only spending when it's election time? That's what it is. Right? And why are people that are part of the party mechanism now complaining that the money that they expect to be spent around election time is not being spent? Why is so much money being put into winning an election and it appears no money is being put into governing the spaces that you won?
My thing is, we have three sitting cabinet ministers that are for Grand Bahama today. Two today.
Three cabinet ministers?
Three sitting ministers or MPs.
Okay, we got Minister for Grand Bahama. And producer, let's prep the call. Minister for Grand Bahama. Mm-hmm. What is... They had Obi was the MP for West End and Grand Bahama, and he would have sat as a cabinet minister. Who's mm-hmm. the third?
See,
because there's only
right,
five.
Right,
no, we, have
only,
five. We have five.
Yes, only five.
We
so,
have five.
So you have three...
Parliament?
On Grand Bahama.
Right.
There's only
Grand
five.
Bahama, five of them?
Yeah.
Right.
So there's the three FNM. And then you got the Minister of Grand Bahama.
Two, three, five,
and
four.
You have the West End... West Grand Bahama seat.
And what has been the results from this?
I don't know. But we have a caller.
I mean,
we have a caller. But
having that number, I mean, I'm looking at the number.
I wanted to also concentrate also that Kingsley Smith is responsible for writing some of the training for the Progressive Liberal Party. So he's a senior member. That's I found that interesting.
Is he a senior member?
According to writing the whole
I mean, whole you can line. Write something, but that doesn't mean that you're a senior member.
Didn't you embrace it? No, man. You got to be senior to get embrace it. Let's go to the caller. Go ahead, caller. Can you hear me?
Good morning. How are you guys today?
Good, thank
morning,
you.
Morning.
I'm fine, thanks. Just remember now, Mr. Kingsley Smith came out of the Attorney General office before he was appointed to the passport office, okay?
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, no disrespect to Ms. Lyons, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if you enter a race and you want to go to the media, so when the opposite side hit back at you, right, you can't get mad.
Why you right. use the word hit back? Why such violent language?
Why use the word opposite
listen,
side?
Listen,
the same side.
I mean, you could use your lawyer term all you want, right? This is politics. Nothing personal, you know.
It is personal. See, stop
well,
right there. No, no.
Personal, you need
it's
not.
It. Y'all stop talking that foolishness. It
no,
is
no, no.
personal.
Miss Green.
Y'all take it personal.
All right,
y'all go
please.
Beneath the dirt. And
no,
then
no, no,
demand that we call y'all honorable men and women.
But that's a political
okay,
atmosphere, though.
Just if Mr. Gibson could come out publicly on a talk show, right? I mean, on a radio thing. I might have the clip, right?
Uh-huh.
And say he's supporting Robin Lyons because of some incident with him and Fred. That is totally wrong.
He did not say that.
Yes, he did. I have the video.
He said they need new leadership
listen,
as a chairman.
Listen, I have the video.
I have it right here, too. Right here. I can share it and make sure, because we shared what inside here. He said that the chairmanship needs new life and new energy.
New blood.
And he didn't say he'll support.
Here's my point. Why do you all insist that politics is this way? Because here's what the point is. If you cannot convince me,
uh-huh.
see, because you're not convincing me that you can shift the way that politics are done,
uh-huh.
Why you think that that's an endorsement to vote for you? If you're telling me that politics is always going to be this way.
But on the other hand, let me tell you this because I was there. Okay? In 2017, when the PLP party lost the election,
mm-hmm.
It was about 10 of us, along with Mr. Mitchell, that helped build those branches, okay? Ms. Lyons was nowhere to be found. After those branches.
Because she was 12 in 2017.
After those branches were built, okay? Then Mr. Mitchell gave Ms. Lyons the hem to continue to keep the branches alive, okay? But Mr. Mitchell is the one single-handedly, along with about 10 other persons, that helped build those branches. And if you don't believe, you don't have to believe me, you can go to every branch and ask them who built those branches.
No, let me ask this. Was Mr. Davis there amongst that 10?
Mr. Davis also was invited to branch meeting.
No, I want to know if he was amongst the 10. Listen to me. This like a question. Like specific questions.
Go ahead.
Was he a part of the 10?
Mr. Davis.
This was, yes or no.
I'll call him the number 11 or 12.
Now the number's changing.
When he's invited.
No, man. Okay? The number's changing.
It is a 10 or 11.
Listen to the point. He was invited. He didn't come.
He didn't come.
But Paul, see, you said, okay, I'm just saying, you call off 10.
Yes, then, I said, Mr. Davis.
Then you said we can call him.
He's invited to come.
Right.
Okay?
Did he come?
Yes, he did.
To every meeting?
Yes, he did. Not every meeting. I'm saying to you.
What about Chester Cooper? Did he come? Or was he invited?
Chester only 12.
Was he invited?
He only 12, man.
Chester Cooper, was he invited, though?
Chester Cooper. At the time, Chester Cooper spent most of his time in Exuma trying to build a branch in Exuma.
And in 2017?
In 2017. Okay. Uh-huh. Like I said, you remember when the FNM was saying that Mr. Davis was traveling on a diplomatic passport, they had that thing going around?
Yeah.
Mr. Davis been to several branches and proved that he was traveling on his regular passport, okay? He showed the persons in the branch
his travel
regular
to,
passport.
To, with passport so when I go to Family Island.
Pardon me?
I don't travel with passport when I go to the Family Island.
No, he took the passport with him.
You're trying to be sarcastic this morning.
No, I just said I don't take passport when I go to the Family Island.
Are we talking about the work that the people put in? Or are we talking about...
Pause. Let me ask you a couple of questions. Let's get back to this political culture thing, right?
Go right ahead.
I cannot endorse the idea that politics is what it is, and the Bahamian political class is helpless to fix it.
No, you're
that's
correct.
That's an indictment against them.
But you're absolutely correct on that. So I think it's time for the politics to change and change the narrative. But at the end of the day, the Bahamas wasn't just developed in 50 years. It took us a long time to get where we are in 50 years. It took the United States of America far more than 50 years to get where we are today.
But if we don't make the shift now, it'll take us even longer to shift in the direction we feel we need to go.
I would like to see candidates debate. I would like to see where we have a platform for these candidates to basically come out and sit on a panel or a board.
We had a platform and the politicians refused to engage it.
Yes, I'm saying that is if we intend to go forward, that is the actual push we need to do.
You're absolutely correct. That's why the PLP intends to change the entire colonialistic
anti-. So are we going to see the candidates debate where candidates have an opportunity to speak about what it is that they currently do within the constituency?
Let me ask you another question. Can the PLP administration, this one or a future one, can they lead that, A, the political shift, B, lead us into a new frontier with Mr. Mitchell as frontline politician?
From his experience in foreign affairs and traveling all around the world and getting to meet foreign counterparts, right? He has the experience on a dime's notice. He could pick up the phone and call a foreign counterpart and get some things done.
All right, but God forbid, on a dime's notice, he could pass away. Does that mean all of the
institutions? Everything collapses.
That's what we've seen happening in our country.
Listen, caller, I want to thank you. Thank you very much.
No
don't mind these boydom in the studio with us
break. No, we got to go to break soon, but I want to get this caller in just to say, and then we go to break. Go ahead, caller, and we go to break in 30 seconds. Go ahead.
Morning,
sir.
Again, the bottom line is that there's a problem in the PLP, all right? I believe if the PLP, if the delegates in the PLP don't deal with this problem, what Shane Gibson, Ms. Robert Lyons talking about, and a lot of PLPs have a problem with, and the problem is Brave Davis, the leader, and Fred Mitchell, the chairman, the way they hostage and the way they conducting themselves, like this party is their own. It's never been this way. It's the worst ever. And if they don't deal with them in this convention, the delegates and everybody, We have to deal with them to the polls if God spare life. They need to consider that. The PLP need to understand it's a problem. That's the bottom line. That's what people need to consider. It is a problem, and and one side is carrying on like there's no problem, and it's one big happy family, a bunch of foolishness.
We hear you. Let's take this commercial break, and Aaron, I'll have you respond on the next side. Guys, we're on the AM Mashup Wednesday. We're analyzing by-election and, of course, the chairmanship race in the PLPs in the convention. But we will be right back.
Man done.
The public is advised that East Street will be closed from Friday, November 10th, 2023 at 5 p.m. until Monday, November 13th, 2023 at noon. As a result, vehicular traffic will be unable to access East Street from Shirley Street to East Hill Street. We apologize for any inconvenience this may cause and sincerely appreciate your patience and understanding.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
The holiday season is upon us, and everyone's going to be looking for those special items on their gift list. Merchants, here's your opportunity to have your products placed in the Nassau Guardians Holiday Gift Guide. This year, shoppers are going to be searching for perfect presents at the right price. Anything from a family island weekend getaway to electronics, jewelry, and even clothes. For one low price, you can have your ads published twice this December in the Nassau Guardians Holiday Gift Guide. Deadline for registration is Wednesday, November 30th. Be sure to contact your Nassau Guardian sales agent or call the Nassau Guardian directly at 302-2300. Be sure to ask about our 15-30-second Christmas radio commercial bonanza.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
The Nassau Guardians Holiday Gift Guide. Our gift to you. Because Christmas is...
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
And welcome back to Guardian Radio in the AM with C.A. Newry. We have the last few minutes left. I'll put this question to both my panel, Ian Munnings, of course, Aaron Green. Is there disgruntledness within the PLP party? Is there uneasiness amongst the PLP party? And should that be addressed at the convention? We keep on hearing the rumblings. We keep on hearing that there's one side and this next side and that people are unhappy. And this is why the chairman is being challenged, because there are people saying that it's y'all. Y'all ain't listening to us and I am angry and y'all need to deal with my issues and nobody's addressing the issues. And this kumbaya holding hands on the rally stage say we all together ain't real.
But that's what convention is all about. All the internal party issues... That's what the convention is for, right? And that's the tension, the question of if they're going to be talking about national issues or internal party issues. They should be talking about both. They should have the capacity to talk about both, because the former, the internal party issues, inform how the latter, the state, national, governmental issues, will be addressed in the convention. For me, what my concern is, will... issues being raised by constituents in West Grand Bahama and Bimini be raised at the convention floor, and will substantive measures be taken to address them? Not just crafting of promises for the campaign trail, but crafting of policies, potential policy initiatives to address the concerns. I got the quick article, Bimini residents voice concerns and needs ahead of upcoming by-election. Bimini has 4 of the 14 polling stations in the constituency. A seawall is needed. One resident claimed the island's lone ambulance had been down for the entire year. A seawall is needed around part of the island. We know they need fire truck. I don't care what side of Bimini you're on, you need extra fire truck. Seawall, rundown condition of the old administrator's building and customs compound in Bimini. One resident said, don't matter who wins for Bimini because the money is never invested in Bimini. It always goes back to Nassau. So that's an issue about allocation of national and community resources. And then another resident said, paying bills is challenging for customers without a bank card. And the high number of, allegedly, the high number of illegal taxi operators on the island. These are some of the concerns coming out of Bimini, and I wonder if they will be addressed with real substantive policies or just great creative promises.
I want to thank you, Aaron Green. I want to thank you, Ian Munnings. As we continue our march towards the by-election, considering our march towards the PLP convention, we'll continue this discussion for the rest of the week as we try to analyze what exactly is to be anticipated and expected, what ordinary people are not analyzing and critiquing, just for the betterment of the whole country. This has been Guardian Radio in the AM with C.A. Newry. Have a wonderful day.